Hey guys, your boy Pure Prayers, and welcome back to my previous 16 Liverpool Chroma, where last off I started off season 3. He with the Liverpool boys. He's in this little continuing on from my first two Premier League wins. In this episode, I'm facing the Saints as they're traveling to Anfield to get their asses kicked. And then I have my first Capital One Cup game of the season when I play QPR. But first, let's play the Saints. It's the first team, except Tim is playing instead. Jordan Henderson and Philippe Coutinho is back from his injury. Let's do this. This could easily become the first team at some point this season. And with Henderson dropping down to maybe the second team. I don't know what's going to happen with Jordan Henderson. Also, if you guys missed my pack up yesterday, that I uploaded yesterday, you need to go and watch it. I'm not going to spoil it, but I pack an amazing player. Or do I pack a blue? You will have to wait and see. That is the $1 million question that only watching the video will answer. So, if you didn't see the video yesterday, hey, go and watch it. Because it was amazing. Right now, let's focus on being the Saints. Get a nice early go. Start here with Bale. It's the team he graduated from the academy of. There's Nathaniel Clyne playing against his former club as well. His right hand side is very Southampton-ish with Clyne and Bale. Neymar going for the bicycle kick. Bit of a piss take there by the Brazilian. But that's his priority. That's his priority. He wanted to go for the bicycle kick. For whatever reason. There's Bale. Carlos, you didn't have a chance, mate. You didn't have a chance. And I ran straight into Wayama Bridge. I probably scored there had I not ran straight into Wayama. I mean, Wayama doesn't need my help to get the ball off me. He's a pretty strong tackler. Correa! Yes, and it's not offside. There, it's 1-0. Yeah, it's bagging all the goals at the start of this. And I think we're seeing the early contender for top goal scorer. Finished runner up to the Coutinho last year. I think Correa is dead set on going for top spot this year. I think that's his fourth, maybe fifth goal already in what is only the third game. Or I shouldn't have skipped past before it told me how many goals he actually has. Rain. Tiedemans. Oh, the Belgian. With the skills. Oh, Wayama with another good tackle. Oh. Or did I run into him again? I'm going to say it was a Wayama tackle. Frame. To Nathaniel Clyne. Looking for the pass. He's firing Bale. Ah. We're now played by Bertrand. Tim Ants Did he slip or did he trip? Either way, he fell on his face, which I'm sure all of you are going to laugh at. Oh yes, Nathaniel Klein has won the ball back. Back end, Correa is offside. No point run, boys, you're offside. Make him work for the pass. Yes. Yes. No. Yes. Coutinho won the ball off Barca. And now there's the chance for Coutinho. Looking for the space. Finds the space. Scores. There's the top goal scorer from last season. It's off the mark. Who knows? I thought it might be a one season thing. Maybe Coutinho will keep scoring loads of goals. Who knows? Maybe he's going to become a mad goal scorer. Everyone will be after him. They won't get him, but first for the season, Coutinho in his first game is off the mark. If you're Correa, that probably worries you, considering how many goals Coutinho scored last season. As soon as he was off the mark, he was away. He was banging them in. Coutinho again. This time he might turn provider for Correa. Correa, 3-0. Oh, Coutinho does turn provider. Or almost immediately. He correct? Yeah, out. And Bertrand tried to pull him back. Ekpa failed miserably, and Correa slots it home. With peak accuracy. And he gets a hug from Tiemens to celebrate. Why not? That's his fifth goal in the Premier League in what is only the third game. And we're not even halfway through the third game. And he's already on a hat trick. And a goal and an assist in his first start of the season, his first appearance of the season from Philippe Coutinho. So Seems like it's nothing is changing much from last season. Jeff Correa would love a chance to complete his hat trick. Maybe from the corner. Keeper's off his line. But he's going to get back in before I get the ball back in. I don't know if Klein is going to get there. Nope, and there's the halftime whistle. I've only had one shot on target, according to this, and yet I'm 3-0 up. How does that work? Even the thing says I have, even the little pitch thing, it has two dots on it. I mean, I should have two. Sort your shit out, EA. This isn't good. Southampton will need to get an early goal in the second half if they want to get back into this. Or if they want to even have a shot getting back into this. Goal of this season is even less goals than last year. And I know I can do that. Penalty. Ooh. If I wasn't 3-0 up, I'd probably be a bit pissed that I didn't get that. Although, maybe it would have been a bit of a light penalty, I don't know. Obviously, the referee didn't see it as a penalty. He didn't even see it as a foul. Apparently. Neymar plays to Royce. Royce is onside. Correa. Shoot. Yes, he's got the hat trick. The Royce shot was saved. The Correa shot was not. Foster, he tried his best to save it, to be honest. Just couldn't get it out. But it's in. It's 4-0. That's his sixth season already. And that's his hat trick complete. Southampton's chances of winning this match are fading pretty rapidly, if I'm being honest. And you apply the bail. Neymar is offside. Calm down, Neymar. We're 4-0 up. I mean, you don't have to get angry. I mean, it's not like it's 0-0 when you were offside in those, like, the 90 minutes. Like, if that was the case, then I would be pissed too. But, you know, there's no reason to get angry. We can calm down, you know, we can enjoy ourselves a little, you know. 4-0 up against the Saints at home. Exactly. He, screwed that there might be a comeback in the works. If anything, I might end up embarrassing him as much as Liverpool did when the teams met in the Capital One Cup in real life. Although that was 6-1 and Southampton were 1-0 up at one point. And then that went to ratchet pretty goddamn quickly. Foster tripping over Coutinho, who went in for a diving header. That definitely didn't happen on that night, because Foster wasn't playing. I assume he's injured. Thank you, Atletico Madrid. They weakened Chelsea. What? Thank you, Atletico Madrid. You're alright. You're alright, kids. You're alright. Yes, Chelsea, who were the only team who kind of gave me a challenge last season, have lost Hazard is their best player, or when he's in form. He's definitely their highest rated player, and now he is gone. Oh, Chelsea, what are you thinking? The men's show is blocked by Wayama itself for a throw. I didn't actually know that transfer had happened. I must have missed that. I saw he made a transfer request at Hazard, but I didn't know he had already moved. Maybe that's just it telling me he's subject of a bid from Atletico Madrid? Who knows? Anyway, Neymar has header in his second of the season. In the fifth of the match, it's 5-0. Well, 30 points are... They're confirmed, aren't they? Yeah, Mane, no. You're an idiot. We've had enough of your bullshit. Wow. Are you serious? Aw, yes. Thank goodness. You didn't make a mistake. Well, I did make a mistake, but I wasn't punished for said mistake. That's it, Foster. And there we go, there's the full time whistle. Oh, Correa's gonna get the match ball. what he deserves after that performance. It's a hat trick. Probably a man match as well. Why didn't really he look? I assume he got man match. I mean, he did get three goddamn goals. Be a little weird if he didn't get man match. Are you serious, Morales? As soon as he goes up to 61, I'm dropping him from training. If he wasn't so close, I would have dropped him already. Brazil. As tempting as that is, I don't want to manage any international team. Apparently Paraguay want me as well, so there's that. Nope, he did. Did move. 91 million. I can see. Actually, yes, I am going to be rotating the team, but you're not the you're not the goalkeeper of this squad. Dragowski is. Guns up here. I'm gonna play American and Costa. Because I can. That's a home game. I thought it was an away game. I did think it was an away game. I'm not gonna lie. Do this. Oh, come on, straight off Origi. He first time Origi is playing since his long injury. Well, first official game he's playing, because I used him a few times in the preseason. Pressure on Wisdom, he might make a mistake. Turbe to Origi. Yokari. Sandra. Who can't seem to get the ball away. He. Skiglio. Emre. He can. Can! Ooh, Ochoa, he blocked it. Dick. Draw a knife. Whoops it in. Looking for D-Walk Origi. It's headed away. No. And then Andre Wisdom from a Liverpool play. Here in this career. Go to court. Chris. Gets it away. Okay. Right out. Oh. I was going to say. He was fouled, but the advantage was given. Instead, it's we pull back to the free kick now. I don't know why it's telling me to use Jordan Ibe with his 29 free kicks. His 29 free kicks. Yeah, I'm sure I'll get right on that. No, it's gonna be one. Well, it's me. And that was a terrible free kick. I mean, probably would have been better if that was on. Side. Probably should have used some Probably should have used someone else there. Ah, well, lesson learned. Lesson learned. And Nacho. Power through the challenge, but he did lose the bull for the second time around. So it's gonna be toilet. Yeah. You're up against a big ass jerk. German. I don't like your chances, Junior Hoylet. I really don't. Chen. Pass to Martin Costa. Costa! Straight at Smithers. That's not excellent. That was pretty disappointing, actually. Off the challenge, I am Nacho. Back to Moreno. To Nacho. I am Nacho again. You're up, Origi. That's in! Oh, yes! Is it Costa goal or is it a known goal? I think they're getting it to Costa. Costa and the, was it Ochoa? I don't know this QPR. No, it wasn't Ochoa. It was the other defender. What's that defender's name? No, it's given it to Costa. So, obviously, whoever the other defender was, I don't know the other defender's name. I don't know the QPR team that well. I haven't seen their team in ages. Was it Wisdom? Oh, it was Wisdom. It was Andre Wisdom. I did see it was number 6 in the replay. So that's who it was. It was Andre Wisdom. It was almost an own goal for the former Liverpool man. But no, they gave it to Costa. Obviously, Wisdom did not hit it. Costa hit it, and Costa hits it again, and he puts it in! The player you're liking a bit to doubt, so bit of a more of an eye for goal than David Silva. Silva doesn't score that many goals. It's 2 in the space of a couple of in-game minutes for Martin Costa. Definitely see a lot of potential in Martin Costa. Yeah. And if he keeps scoring goals like that, he'll definitely fulfill that potential. It's probably going to be a foul, yeah. I could tell as soon as it happened. And it's just one of those, isn't it? Mario will get rid of that. It's probably going to be the end of the first half. No? Not the end of the first half yet. Oof! Yeah, Smithers hit him right in the face. He's get a nice pack during the halftime. Here we are, it's just a bruise. Might knock the tooth loose. I'd check with your dentist. See, our Premier League teams. Man United are winning at Ipswich. Chelsea are drawing with Leornant. Right. Arsenal, I don't see. Spurs, don't see them. Newcastle drawing, Palace drawing, Norwich drawing. West Brom are winning against Wolves. Arsenal must be playing another night. They're not playing tonight, or at least they're not. They weren't in the among the fixtures that the game showed me. Oh, straight away in the start of the second half, Iheanacho has scored. A beautiful crossing from the wing, and a towering header from the Nigerian. From one striker to another, or Divock to Iheanacho to goal. That's link-up play at its finest. Exactly what I want to see from my two strikers. I want them to be on the same wavelength. And obviously they were, because Nacho, he was in the right place at the right time. The header at home. Now for a 3-0. Fouls and have Emre Can stand on the line just in case. Didn't need it, so it was cleared in the end by Orban. If you're wondering who the hell is Orban, he's a sign I made. It was recommended to me. As much as I'm going to miss Thiago Elu, he wasn't growing, even though I did played him a few times, he scored a couple goals, but, in the end, he wasn't growing. Well, I was recommended this Orban, and then I was told he would grow beautifully, so, hopefully, I will not regret that, this decision. Orban Zare is actually one rank higher than Thiago Loria at 56, so straight away, even if he doesn't end up growing for whatever reason, he'll always be higher than Thiago Loria, because Loria just seemed to be stuck at a 75, and that's a penalty. That's probably a red card too. Ref. It's Andre Wisdom. Is he off? He better be off. Come on. A yellow! How is that a yellow? That's a red card offense any day of the week. That is a red card offense any day of the week. Look at that. There is no way that's a yellow. Mmm. 46. I was hoping he'd have better penalties than that. Might have to work on that. He's gonna miss out on his hat trick because of it. And Iheanacho has bagged his brace. I have two players on hat tricks. Iheanacho and Martin Costa. Splendid penalty. He put away with a unique precision. And I like that. I just noticed that. The QPR fans behind the goal, they were like waving their arms. Was that them trying to distract Iheanacho? And I'm guessing that's what they were trying to do. I never noticed that before. Do all teams do that if you get a penalty at that end here at Anfield? That's actually a pretty smart idea. Credit to QPR fans. And I didn't actually know they did that. even if he had missed, would it really matter? It would still be 3-0. I guess 3-0 is better than 4-0. in the end, it didn't really matter. I didn't actually notice that. Well, I saw it in the replay. I was like, wait, what? Oh, wow. You're damn right that's a yellow. If you'd sent me off, I would have absolutely raged. Like, it would not even be funny how much I'd be raging. Nacho. Is he gonna go for himself? I pressed pass! I wanted to pass it to Martin Costa, not pass it to the goalkeeper! God damn it! Aye, Nacho. Actually, I shouldn't blame him, it was the game's stupid passing method for this year. Seriously, what the hell did they do to passing? And why? Passing was probably the last thing. That was a problem. It always does the wrong thing. Jordan Ibe! Boom! Bottom corner. The young Englishman. And adds his own twist to the tale. 5-0. As they're going for 3 in a row. We get a goal from number 33. Hey, Nacho! Oh, imagine if that had gone in! He parried it as well. It should have been there to pounce, but it doesn't really matter. Look at that! The QPR manager, he's like, peace out, bitches! He can't take no more of this shit. He didn't even shake my hand! What a rotten dick. Chelsea lost to Lorient! Did anyone else see that? They lost! Chelsea. And you expect to challenge me for my title as Premier League champions, and you're losing to Lorient. No disrespect to Lorient, they're a good team, but they're not. They shouldn't be beating Chelsea. No way! They should be beating Chelsea. Even if it was 1-0, they shouldn't be beating Chelsea. That is something else entirely. That was a great laugh. Thanks, Chelsea. I'll be laughing at that all day, without a doubt. Let's hope I don't run into any Chelsea fans. I'll be laughing at them, they'll be like, huh? They wouldn't know. I'm kidding, I wouldn't laugh at Chelsea fans for something that happened in a virtual game. That would be cruel. I'm not that cruel. I'm cruel, but I wouldn't laugh at someone for a virtual result. That would be petty. It's embarrassing. It's an embarrassing result. But it's just a game. Just a game. Anyway, until next time, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, smash the like button and then hit the subscribe button so you never miss any other of my videos. If you are interested in seeing that pack thing it's on. I'll just look at the video. Oh, FIFA 16. Holy shit. And you'll see why the title is holy shit. But until then, till next time, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see